Professor Mark Griep and his wife Marjorie Mickison are Burnett Society members who planned an estate gift that pays tribute to the legacy of a trailblazing woman at UNL.
I'm here in front of the plaque that honors Dr. Rachel Lloyd, who was the first woman chemistry professor in the chemistry department at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln.
Dr. Lloyd was a brilliant woman with many firsts to her name.
This describes how she earned her PhD at the University of Zurich in 1887.
And with that, Lloyd became the first American woman and just the second woman in the world to earn a doctorate in chemistry.
While at the University of Nebraska, who hired her right after she got her PhD, she started analyzing the sugar content of beets grown by Nebraska farmers. And it led to, in 2 years, the first sugar beet factory being built in Nebraska, which happened to be the third one built in the United States.
Mark Griep has been a professor in the chemistry department at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln since 1990. And he feels as though one of his most important contributions to UNL over the past three decades was rediscovering the history of this 19th century chemistry pioneer whose story had been largely forgotten for at least a century.
When I started digging into her story in the 1990s, I was amazed that she had been so well known during the time that she lived and even a couple decades afterwards, but that she had been totally forgotten. Again, it was astounding to me.
So astounding that Professor Griep spent more than 20 years searching high and low for all things Dr. Lloyd related.
These are the oldest scientific instruments in the department. They're called saccharometers. And when I analyzed the manufacturer, they were made during the time that Rachel Lloyd was in the department. And so I'm sure she used these to measure the sugar concentration in the beet extract.
It just totally fit with the way Mark has been pursuing his own family history.
Professor Griep's wife, Marjorie Mickison, is an accomplished abstract geometric painter who really enjoyed the process of watching her husband discover vast amounts of vital information about Dr. Lloyd over a two-decade span.
Every fact that came along was another surprise and, like, Christmas every day, you know. So when he found the newspaper article talking about the time capsule, that was amazing.
This is the copper box that was the time capsule for Avery Hall. And it was assembled in 1916. This is truly the most amazing thing I've ever done, is open a time capsule.
In 2016, Professor Griep and his wife thought so much of Dr. Lloyd and her accomplishments that they decided to create a faculty development fund in both Dr. Lloyd's name and the man who brought her to Lincoln in 1887, Professor Hudson Nicholson.
It's a faculty development fund to kind of give a little bit of help to a professor who is on the tenure track and doing their research and maybe needs, just a little bit of help to push them over the line.
The idea was that people do have a long career, and there are moments when they do need a little extra help, a little bit of financial help to keep things going.
The chair of the chemistry department decides who is eligible to receive assistance from this fund. Mark and Marjorie are Burnett Society members who would highly recommend that others consider giving an estate gift, just like they did.
I think people should think about their legacies.
I think it is a really good idea. Obviously, as a scientist and as an artist, we plan a lot. And thinking about family history, thinking about departmental history, you think about the big long-term arc of how things work. And so after we had hit midlife, we thought, okay, how's this gonna end? How should we plan?
Thanks to this faculty development fund, Dr. Lloyd's legacy will be preserved, and countless other faculty members and future scientists at UNL will get the chance to pursue their research ambitions. If you would like to know more about how you can leave a legacy by making an estate gift, contact the University of Nebraska Foundation Gift Planning Team.